So this is the those ruins, the shrine ruins that we talked as well. And you can see the, the hunter is already in the locale. Here's the camp over here. Just so you know, they already accepted a two-star quest to hunt down a Tetranodon before they came here. So they're just going straight to the Axum to show it off to you. So you can see some kind of cool rock formations around you. He's showing you this beautiful river as well. And oh man, I bet like the air is just really fresh here. Ah, nature. So he's popping into the tent now. And this is the item box and the buddy board. Here you can, he's showing you an option that lets you eat as well. So yeah, the first option is the item box, the second one is the buddy board, and the third one is eat. The fourth one is get out of here. If you go to the top one, the item box, you're able to manage your equipment and change, you know, what you're using. So we're going to have 14 weapons from, you know, like that you've seen in the series before. So I think people are looking forward to a lot of weapons that they've seen in the past. But we'll be talking a lot more about those weapons later, so stay tuned for more information. You know, this is nothing new before, but you had like a lot of money, didn't you, Hiyuko? Apparently in the item box you could see the cash somewhere, and he was like, man, you are rich. It's like, I have been getting the money. So, you saw him just use this on the screen. That was the wire bug. So you can see kind of right below, on the center of the screen, below the feet of the player, these like two little icons that are slowly refilling. That is the wire bug icon. You can use two of them initially, and when you use one of them, you can see it kind of like becomes like temporarily unavailable. So you're able to use two of them quickly in unison in a row, and then obviously you can see them recharging below as well. She was really excited about the fact that you can get on top of that tent. And he wants to add that, you know, you can use the wire bugs to get all over the place, access all sorts of really interesting places. You can go vertically, horizontally. Basically, you just use that aiming reticule that he popped up before, put it in the direction of the direction you want to throw the wire bug, and then there it goes. It's really a free system that gives you a lot of versatility. I bet, you know, we can probably make it up here too. Look. Aha! So, you know, if you're on the edge, you know, you can use them to do like little jumps to get up the over places that are in the way, and you'll get over obstacles. So it's really helpful to have. So you can kind of use the wire bugs to search around the environment and find hidden gathering points and discover really interesting kind of cute little things that we've, you know, included in the game. It's a really great way to kind of explore the world of Monster Hunter Rise. And they're really tall, and he's like, is it okay to jump down? And obviously it is. So it looks like you can use the wire bug as you're falling down to, you know, make it look cooler. But he says actually if you fall and you hit the ground, you still won't take damage. So the wire bug is just entirely if you want to be classy. So we were talking about the wire bug on the bottom, but next you can see to the right of that there is this little icon mesh. We are calling this the action slider, and using that you can issue orders to your Palamute or do other sorts of things. So, you know, like right now he used it to jump onto the back of the Palamute. And while you're on the back, like, you can do dashes and jumps. And the Palamute's actually, you got a little bit of a nice addition. So you can see he kind of grabbed on the edge of that hut and jumped on the top. So, you know, basically, it's really helpful to have the Palamute around to access all these areas and move about quickly. Sorry, I'm going to get off of him really quickly. So you can also use the that action bar to do some communication with your buddies. Like this one, like, sit. Or, you know, like, shake hands. Good dog. You can also do it with the palicos as well. Oh, look how adorable he is. I mean, this has nothing to do with actual gameplay elements. It's just, you know, fun. It's just pure delight. High five, cat. High five. So yeah, the action that lets you use kind of all sorts of things. As you saw, there were actions to do with your animals, with your pet, with your, sorry, your buddies, and you could also do things like summon the Palamute to ride it. So you saw me just kind of do this quick, nice slide down the mountain, and we're in this new area now. So this is the main field of the area. So I talked a little bit about this. You can join on the, you can summon kind of the Palamute to jump on it using the action slider. But if you're near the Palamute, you can also just hold A to like just hop onto his back real quick as a sort of shortcut. He's also showing you that you can use, you can set shortcuts to kind of make it easier to use the commands that you want to use you very often. So you can see he's setting it right now. I've set things to like use healing items and whatnot, sharpen weapons and etc. So you know, the while you're on the Palamute, you're not just moving. You're able to do other things and get all sorts of actions done and you know prepare for battle and whatnot. So next up is you can see this little green thing, right? It's kind of like a little ball that is called an endemic life. So you can collect these to do things like get little buffs like heal or get stamina back or gain other sorts of benefits. It's only these quests, these buffs are temporary. They're only active for the quest that you're on. So we just kind of triggered the bad guy. We pulled him. So we're going to run over here so we can do some other stuff first before we go into the fight. So normally, you see there's now three symbols for the wire bug on the bottom. Before we had only two. So what this is during you know, quests, you can find wire bugs in the wild, that was weird, to actually increase the max amount of wire bug usage you have in that quest by up to three. And that kind of will help you get a little bit more mobility and move around a little bit more. He also mentioned using it with the Palamute, but sorry, I think I missed that little bit. I think he's just talking about climbing the vines that you saw before. So all the buff items that you like are used to from the Monster Hunter series, of course, will remain in the series. This is an entirely new element that they have added to the game. So, you know, like, you can kind of, like, search around the map and discover, like, your best routes to monsters and figure out the best way to play it. There are some that, you know, you don't have to do any of these to win. These are all kind of optional things if you want to go out of your way to find the extra buffs. So it's all, you know, kind of gives you a lot more ways to approach the game. So over here, you can see this kind of a grass thing that he's messing around with it. So you can see over here, he just, like, found a great wire bug in there. And you can use those one that you found to make these super huge jumps, like the one that you just saw. You saw he just leaped up a tremendous distance. So, you know, like searching through the locales, you can find really cool items like this and, you know, endemic lives and wire bugs that will let you maneuver and gain more buffs. It's a really interesting thing that adds rewards to the exploration aspect of the game. So I'm going to grab this little endemic life right here. He's going to jump around through some bamboo.
立ち回るというか、まあ、修行するようなゾーン、エリア以外にもこういった
So outside of the areas that you fight the monsters, like the one that you just saw, there's also these kind of like little side areas that are basically you won't find any large monsters wandering in here, but there's tons of endemic life for you to go around and look in and, you know.There's some like destructible environmental bits that you can go and find hidden monster or hidden, sorry, hidden endemic life, collect them, gain some buffs.
強化することなくとも、まあ、アクションが得意な人であれば、それだけで、モンスターに挑むことが
Of course, you know, like, you know, all these buffs really help you defeat monsters, but, you know, they're not necessary. If you're, you know, really good at these games and you're an experienced veteran of the Monster Hunter series, you can probably go straight into fighting the monsters if you want to. All this stuff is, you know, once again, just an extra bit.
まあ、ステータス上げるようなやつがいたりとか、このようにアイテムとして使えるようなものがいたりとか。
So, the endemic life, definitely do all sorts of things, like there's buffs. There's also some of them that can be used like items and other things. We'll be giving more information about these on a later date, but, you know, right now, I think that's all we're going to say about them. So you can see him.
ガルクすごい。
They were talking about, can we climb up here? And then he's like, yeah, I can check this out. So you can use, the wirebug to get up here if you want to, or you can use the Palamute. There's lots of ways to maneuver around the environment and explore. So, you know, find a way that suits you, find a way that you like, and play the sort of game you want to play.So once you get used to it, it becomes, it starts feeling really nice to just bounce around and move around. So, you know, it kind of changes the way the gameplay is. So, you know, getting used to this new element in the game, this new dynamic mechanic is the word I'm looking for, really kind of changes the gameplay, and you can play around with different play styles and have fun. So now they're going to go and look for the Tetranodon and show you some straight up battle, which I'm sure you're all looking forward to.
そうですね。2番のエリアからちょうど、
So you can see that kind of floating around him. I think that's a,
今回ですね、ペイントボール。
Another bit of endemic life. So there's no paintball, in this game. But you can see on the bottom left, there's that sort of map, and that will generally show you where a monster is on. And if you know what the monster is, it will show up as a little symbol, but, the question marks are monsters that you haven't kind of encountered yet, so you don't know what they are.
袋型の小型の生き物がいるんですけど、まあ、それを放って、まあ、モンスターの位置を。
There's also like this special item that kind of looks like a little owl that you can send off into the distance that will search out and scout out the locations and types of monsters and so on.
はい。
A scouting item, I suppose.
四つの窓の方なんですけど、まあ何回かとお話とかもさせてもらってるんですけど、まあ、食欲は旺盛で今も。
So, now we're showing off the Tetranodon, and this is an amphibious, hefty chunk, as I think I said yesterday. He's really big already, but while he's fighting, you can see him now, he's actually pretty big up. Once he eats something, he gets extra full. He gets just practically pudgy. And what happens when that happens, he gets heavier and his attacks become stronger. It also changes his attack patterns a little bit. So, you know, he moves slower because of this, so it's a nice kind of like different way of fighting the monsters. So now I'm going to show you a little bit more about the dual blades. Wow, look at that. Look at that stomp. So he's just hitting it normally now, but...So, right now he's used the wire bugs, but you're able to use the wire bug in coordination with your attack, like as you're seeing he's doing right here with the dual blades to do some extra attacks. And every weapon has a number of different patterns and things you can do, you know, collaborations attacks, that you can, coordinated attacks you can make with a wire bug. And a lot of them really sort of go well with the sorts of weapons you're using. So like, you know, this one lets you increase your mobility and do extra damage at very specific points.
おぼろがけっていう、まあ、かけ虫を前方に放って、
So I'm going to show you one right now. It looks like he's going to throw the wirebug forward. So you throw the wirebug forward, and if the monster makes an attack into it, it gives you a chance to make a counter attack against it. So there are really cool ways to use the wirebug in sort of a supportive role for your main weapon. And do I think he? Yeah, he just showed you right there. It was a little bit cool, so it was kind of hard to see. But right as the monster attacked him, he threw out the wirebug, which is going to make that really cool counter attack. There was again, I think. So depending on, you know, the power of the wire bug, according to the attack that you make, you might use one or maybe two of these wire bug icons on the bottom. You can use, you know, you can use them for this one. You know, there's ways to use this to make attacks. There's ways to use it as an evasion. We hope everybody kind of experiments and tries to find out ways to use these various abilities to support their own particular game styles. So you can see this Palamute over here. He's, you know, fighting. So one thing people are probably worried about is that the Palamute, you know, does have HP. He can get hurt, but he will never die. So even if you get really, even if it gets really hurt bad, he'll kind of run off and not be available for a bit, healing up, eating doggy treats or something. So I think we still have time. He's thinking about ending the gameplay here, but we have a little bit more time, so he's going to maybe do it a little bit more. They're kind of discussing, what do we want to do now? I'm sure a lot of people would want to see this whole fight out and see everything. But it looks like they're going to. Okay, so we got a little bit more time. So you see these question marks? So he's going to run over and encounter them. And he actually doesn't know what they are. Oh man. Man, look at this book. So yeah, we have this guy who just ran over here. Oh my god. So I think they said the name of it. Sorry, I don't recognize the name of that monster in English. But he's adorable. Also terrifying. So there's also, it sounds like he is a monster from the previous series. So we have quite a few of them in this game as well. So this is, I guess, a surprise reveal of this little monster right here. Dojo. It sounds like the Japanese is Dojo. I might have missed that. Sorry, I'm sure everybody who's watching this is more familiar with this monster than I am. So, yeah, one interesting thing that we like to talk about is in this game, kind of different from the other previous Monster Hunters, is the player character talks a lot more than it used to. You know, shout and yell and taunt and so on. But there isn't option in the menu that allows you to kind of adjust this. So if you think, like, you know, you don't want to hear your hunter talk, you want him to just be quiet and stab things, you're able to change that and make it more just about, you know, the quiet, solitary hunter sort of thing. So yeah, it's customizable. You can adjust the rate of character speech in the game. So they're kind of reiterating that. They're talking about, you know, like, if you really want to listen to the character as the character, or if you really want to focus on the action, you can kind of mix around with that. So yeah, we hope you, everybody's looking forward to trying out all these new different abilities and seeing the monsters and everything. So it sounds like we have some more time. So more time than we initially thought we'd had. So we're gonna go. So we're gonna go on a little bit more of a, you know, like a walkabout. I guess we have some leftover time, so we're gonna go on a walkabout and explore a little bit more. So I think they're gonna try to. You see that? So yeah, this is the first, you know, actual gameplay footage of this. So, like, you know, let's go extra far. Let's go the extra mile and show. Literally, let's go the extra mile and show some more stuff. So there. So this is also something that he doesn't know what's going to be awaiting him in this direction. So yeah, like that kind of like triple wire bug thing he did there. She commented on how like really nice that felt to see and do. And he's like, yeah, this is that mobility, the kind of light, the ability to run around and be mobile and explore the game. That's a really fun part of this. So they're just going to keep exploring. Oh, wow, look at him climb that cliff. And he can use the wire bug to kind of check out where you want to go like that as well. So you can also, for the most part, we showed him climbing the wall to straight, but you can go sideways and a little bit more, all sorts of directions. It's a, we wanted to make it a really easy, easy controls that are simple and easy to understand, but also gives you this really cool, strong feeling of, you know, traversing this environment and exploring all these interesting places. Well, let's run over here. He's like, let's go over there. He's like, is there something over there? I have no idea. So they don't really know where to go. They're just kind of wandering around. Like, yeah, wander over here. Let's see what we can say. Oh, here, see this little guy. She's commenting on how cute he is. And he's saying this is kind of like a tanuki, like a raccoon dog. And it's kind of like a little mascot character of this. I guess he doesn't realize you're there, or maybe he doesn't care. Yeah, he's a friendly little guy. He doesn't really care. He had this kind of look like, oh, what you're doing here? I'm just going to do what I want. All right, I think we're going to end it there.